Hi, and welcome back. We are in our designated lab space, and we're going to talk a little bit more in detail about the color indicator test that we use to detect the presence of blood. And if you recall, that test was called the Kastle-Meyer test. Now, that is just the name of the test, and actually the name of the reagent is a little difficult to spell. It's phenylphthalein, and if you need me to spell that for you, just send me an email. But phenylphthalein, or the Kastle-Meyer test, is just one of a lot of different indicator tests that can be used either in the field or in the lab or in the teaching labs or your eye cure. Other tests include something called O-toluidine or tetramethylbenzidine. And all of these tests, including another one we're going to discuss later on, have the same chemical reaction basis. They're all oxidation reduction reactions. So for the color indicator test, your product of the oxidation reduction reaction is a change in color. Now, this is a swab that we used in our earlier crime scene testing. And if you recall, it really wasn't that pink after we did the initial testing. And if you also recall, I said that a positive reaction within 10 seconds, this development of a bright pink color, is a positive. But as you can see, it's pink and even pinker. So doesn't that mean that this is even more blood? Not necessarily. If you go back to that chemical reaction, oxidation reduction reaction, you'll come on to the idea that if you leave these reagents out too long, they will oxidize. They will eventually turn pink, even in a negative test situation. So what I'm going to do to show you that is add our three reagents to a blank sterile swab, and at the end of this segment we'll see how pink this non-stained swab is. We'll put that here at the beginning. So just as a recap, here is a stain that was collected from our crime scene, red-brown stain. And I am going to add reagent A, which in this case is ethanol, reagent B, which is a reduced phenylphthalein reagent, and reagent C, which is 3% hydrogen peroxide. And here is our brilliant pink color, positive within 10 seconds, indicative of a positive Kastle-Meyer test. Another thing to be aware of when you're developing your eye cure or testing evidence, blood can look very different on different surfaces that it's on. You typically think of blood as this bright red, shiny substance, but as you can see on this hat, this white hat, this blood here, which I've tested previously, shows more, it's a little bit more brown, a little darker, may not necessarily scream possible blood stain to you. Now this sock, which has a number of different stains on it, not only does it have some greenish stains, greenish brown, but also some red-brown staining here on the foot, as well as at the ankle. Again, I know these are blood because I put the staining there, but this might be something that could be overlooked, not only at a crime scene, but also kind of discounted in a research type of situation, only because it's not presenting itself as red-brown staining, I'm blood. And actually all of this brown staining here, which looks like maybe somebody wore the sock on a dirty parking lot, this is actually wiped up blood. So you can see there's a lot of different treatments that blood could go through, and then you and your students could then in turn test to see what type of reaction you might get with the Kastle-Meyer test. Now this is a piece of carpet, and here is this red-brown stain, nice and visible, and then on down to the end of the carpet, the stain decreases in visibility, increases in dilution, decreases in visibility. Now, another pro to using the Kastle-Meyer test is its sensitivity. And there are stains here, as you can see, or maybe not. And a pro of the Kastle-Meyer test is it can actually test positive on a non-visible stain, which can be good and can be bad. In a research situation, that can be of benefit because you can further test how dilute can we get to get a reaction. But in a crime laboratory, it's not necessarily ideal because we won't know, can we get DNA analysis on this? Now these carpet squares here have examples of stains and substances that can look like blood. And so we're going to do a little testing here. So audience at home, kind of guess in your head which one of these you think might test for blood. I will give you the answers afterwards. So I'm going to wet a couple of swabs with deionized water, and I'm going to test our two stains here. I'm going to call this stain A, and I'm going to make sure that I rub this nice and hard to get a good color transfer. And here is the color transfer from stain A. Okay, I'm going to put that down, and then I'm going to swab stain B. Now stain B, probably doesn't look like blood, right? It looks a little orangey, it looks a little icky, crusty. And then here's the color transfer from stain B. Now looking back at stain A, this area here that's circled, that really doesn't look like that red-brown staining either. So you know what? We're gonna test stain B first, just to kind of get that out of the way. This kind of orangey color, probably not blood, but let's see. I'm gonna move some materials forward. I'm gonna add my reagent A, which is ethanol. Reagent B, the Kastle-Meyer reagent, reduced phenylphthalein. And then reagent C, which is my hydrogen peroxide. And I should see a beautiful pink color within 10 seconds if it is positive. But I am not seeing that color. You don't know it, but I'm counting to 10 in my head. I am not seeing that color. So therefore, this is a negative test. It's a negative indication for blood. So in the crime lab, this sample would not go forward for further DNA testing. Now, much like we did with our blank stain, I'm gonna put this negative result off to the corner, and we're gonna take a look at it after we complete our testing here to show you why you need to read these tests within 10 seconds. So just a recap of what we've done with this stain A right here. Not really looking like blood a lot. I'm not seeing a lot of red-brown. Honestly, it could be something like soda that's been spilled on the carpet. So I'm going to add my reagent A, ethanol. Reagent B, which is the Kastle-Meyer reagent. And then reagent C, which is the hydrogen peroxide. Oh my goodness, look at this. Brilliant pink color indicative of a positive reaction for Kastle-Meyer. On a stain that didn't really look like blood. So this kind of demonstration here shows you that the scope of what one can do for research just involving blood or blood lookalikes can encompass. There are some known false positives with the Kastle-Meyer test. Since the Kastle-Meyer test is based on an oxidation reduction reaction, there are substances that contain oxidizers, such as bleach, or other peroxidases, such as horseradish. Some other well-known false positives are some types of metals, okay? Now, when you think of bleach and horseradish, those don't look visibly like blood, but what if they were mixed in with some type of red-brown material? Could you mimic a positive reaction? So that's just one idea for an eye cure that can be done with something as simple as materials that you can get at the grocery store and the Kastle-Meyer test. So now let's look at our blank and negative samples. We'll show you here, especially our blank sample, there is some pink color change. And again, I just want to stress the importance of why reading this test within that 10 seconds is important, because these will continue to oxidize and just get pinker over time. Not only is the Kastle-Meyer a sensitive test, it's quick, it's easy, and you can actually perform it without blood if there's an issue with the purchase of biological materials. So just some food for thought for one idea for one of your eye cures. So now, let's go back to the crime scene and look at another method that can be used not only at the crime scene, but in the laboratory as well.